A very good morning to everyone.
Good morning.
It's a nice gathering and a professional meet, a discussion, a forum, whatever we call it as. It's a blessed day for us to be here, and it's not going to be a session, but it's going to be an interaction to see what data science and big data stands for managers. I'm specifically looking at connecting this topic from a PMI perspective, from a manager's perspective, from a leader's perspective. The whole world is talking about data today. So I hope we have professionals here from all industries, telecom, IT, retail. That's where project management actually connects people. In today's world, how this big data or data science is really ruling us and how it impacts the life of the managers is going to be the discussion for the day. What have you heard about big data so far?
As
I said, I'm not going to give you any technology, any detailed description. I'm not a technology evangelist on big data. But still, we can see how we can make some wonders on this word buzzword. Yes.
Voluminous of data.
Velocity.
VVs.
Yes.
Structure.
I got two V's. Volume and?
Velocity and?
Velocity and?
Variety.
One more V is there.
Variety.
Excellent. Variety. So people are dealing with data in these three sets. Volume, variety and velocity. Do you think all the business has got such a type of data? Voluminous data, variety of data, and the data which has to be processed with the high velocity. Do you think all the industry today have got it?
Yes.
Telecom, retail, healthcare, IT.
Yes, yes, yes.
All the industry, do you think they all have got big data?
Yes.
The data is so huge, so voluminous. May or may not be. Yes, of course. When an organization says you have been there for 80 years, 100 years, 20 years, 15 years, the tradition itself talks about the data volume. Every company is weighed by the data volume today. Every organization is weighed by the data volume. Rich or poor depends on the volume of the data you have. Higher the volume of the data you have got, your organization is the richest organization in the world. If you can do some wonders with the data science, the wisdom you have to extract from it. Yes. For a manager, what we need to do with this 3V?
Predict the future.
We have to predict the future of our company. Current status plus future. Excellent. First, let us understand what is happening currently in the organization. Based on that, plus you can also predict the future. So every manager in the organization is going to do that. They'll give the big volume of data to us. We'll go fetch in and handle the data and come back and give the insights about the current business and future business. Are we going to do that?
Offstream,
those things.
Operation team
does that. What are we going to do? What is our role in this?
More than predicting, it is about taking right decisions based on the data, backed on the data, rather than guesswork.
Rather than really working on it, making decisions, then what else could be our roles?
Identifying the right data.
Identifying the right data.
Take the right business decisions based on data.
Make the right decisions based on that. What else?
As a manager, we are not processing the data.
We are not sure processing the data. So somebody will be coming with the results from a lab test result or from a clinic. The result will come to you, doctors. You have to interpret and make decisions. Then what else? There is a huge amount of capital expenses involved. So funding. So you have to negotiate with the management to run such kind of initiatives which you get as an insight from the data analytics. Correct? You are getting some data analytics and you are getting some insights. So you're getting some results which may lead to financial decision making, right? So that's a very huge responsibility we have. So we are going to work on that. What else?
Data
do some risk analysis.
Do a risk analysis then.
Infrastructure.
Infrastructure needs analysis.
Customer
sentiments. So basically this whole world connects us to the emotions of a customer. Very simple for a manager. End of the day, whatever we do here, we are all going to connect the emotions of the customer of your business. That's it. A bank want to promote something on how check can be processed in 3 minutes. In future, they'll have an app. And when you have a check from your friend, you can scan it in the app and put it in your app in your mobile. In 3 minutes, the amount will be credited in your account. They just want to promote it. They're not promoting only on their website. They're trying to post it in LinkedIn or Facebook or Twitter. Why? Customer point. They capture their emotions and their discussions and all these things, and they are going and doing a marketing over there and putting that kind of ads in that particular place and then putting in the other areas as well. So end of the day, this is completely giving way to understand your customers' emotions, feelings, patterns, behaviors. You want only the invoice data of you purchase something in lifestyle showroom. It is a sales report, correct? So many such sales reports are there over a period of years. But from that, they are finding a parent, whenever they purchased the school shoe, they also purchased the school uniform. So whenever they purchase this, they also purchase some color pencils and boxes. Deciding on these patterns, the customer's behavior pattern, they're going to decide in which shelf, in which floor these things has to be properly organized and during which sales season. End of the day, this is what data analytics is going to do. Nothing beyond that. This has been done so far by guessing. Right? Earlier when you had business where you had data, we were promoting our business. We were understanding the customer's emotions and feelings and patterns with our own way of understanding. A unique learning style, understanding style every business would have. They themselves would think, oh, this is what is happening. Either from a salesperson's perspective or from a person who does business from a senior, experienced executive perspective, they make decisions which is based on guess. But data analytics is not giving anything based on guess. It is giving you an accurate, it is predicting and accurately your business pattern, your customer understanding, your customer needs, wants. End of the day, it is an extended subject for customer satisfaction. Data analytics, big data, all these things is an extended subject for making highly a customer satisfied and improve your sales. End of the day, it will end up with sales. So for this, all the organizations are running data analytics as a project. Do you agree with me? Yes? It's going to be an initiative. Before taking this initiative, we also need to connect this with the word called digital transformation. What is meant by digital transformation? So we managers are needed for big data analytics or data science or data analytics. There are three letters. One is called data science, another one is called data analytics, and the other one is called big data. We are needed for data science. Are data analytics or big data? First, let us answer that question and try to connect that with digital transformation as well.
They are all related, data science, analytics, and data.
Okay. Where are we needed?
Data analytics,
we are needed. So, how the difference toggles between data science to data analytics to big data?
One is raw data.
Yes.
And somebody should retrieve the data.
Okay.
And somebody should interpret the data.
Okay.
I think.
Yes, you are right. How do you work on the data, raw data, that itself is the phenomenon of data science first of all, right? So data science as a subject needs three things. What are they? For a given business called retail, if you have these three perspectives, I can say I'm on data science. What is that? You take any retail business, any business model you take in your mind. If I'm going to connect these three perspectives, I'm working on data science. What is that all about?
Data science is
customer information.
Customer information could be your domain expertise, correct? We are going to run a project for Pepsi, or we are going to run a project for Lifestyle, or you are going to run a project for Indian Airways, whomever you are going to do. First, when you want to work on it, business data, a business problem. Customer satisfaction less is a business problem, correct? People are not buying much Pepsi bottles nowadays is a business problem. Even if you put buy one, get two offer, four offer also, people are not at all picking that product from the basket. So that's a business problem. So we are going to analyze on such a data. So first you need a domain expertise. Then the other two factors, can you guess?
Business possibility.
Yes. What else?
Source of product.
Little bit of statistics knowledge to understand. Statistics. Next is you try to see what kind of new technologies today are supporting the perception of data science. So that is where we have to just get connected. The three important aspects: domain expertise, technology, and the statistics. Either it could be a construction industry or a telecom, as I said, IT. We are not selling much on the cloud space like Amazon. Google want to understand why we are not able to sell much on cloud when compared to Amazon. Again, the domain expertise of the IT related business model. The technologies which will help us for data science and the statistics. What is statistics all about? There are some written algorithms, right? You are going to just use it and do it. You are not going to write any algorithm. You should know for a retail data, what kind of algorithm should be applied to see the underlying pattern. For a telecom data, what kind of algorithm should be applied to see the hidden pattern inside? It's going to be an astrology, right? So whenever you feel the word data science, as managers, we ensure on the table, the business related domain expertise is participating. Technology people who can work on like Python or kind of programming tools to analyze the data, those plus SQL knowledge fundamentals, those people are there. Plus some statistician who can apply a lot of algorithms very clearly with the strong mathematical modeling skills. It's not going to be sometimes a born talent with all the three skills. As managers, we will be having resources who will be a combination of these in a team who can work on the data science for this particular organization. The domain expertise, usually whom we call as business analysts or business owners or the data owners of the organization who pursue their business beyond and think about what they need in the business, they'll keep on talking about the business problem. That is the initiation for data science projects. They'll talk about a business problem. We are not doing good. Our revenue has come down 30% in the last 2 years. We want to capture the market space by 95%. Google and Microsoft are competing, saying in cloud, we want to capture the market by 90-95%, where Amazon is already there. He has brought in to sell in seconds, pay-per-use model. He's saying, I'll sell you in seconds, not even in minutes, right? So there's a huge competition. That is the domain expertise we are talking about. So we managers, when we lead these kind of data science related projects, we are connected to a business problem. Basically, this business problem is to improvise your business. Bring in revenue, very simple. Improve your customer satisfaction and bring in the revenue. So you will have people working around you with the domain expertise, and our role as a manager on the top of a data science project is ensure these three things first will connect together so that the projects on data science will get initiated. The domain expertise, the people who have a good knowledge of the technology, when these people give the inputs, these people can work. And usually data scientists will have a statistics knowledge, some technologies, they'll have that. So this is all about the meaning of the word called data science. So it's cooked up a combination of analyzing a business with the technology with some mathematical models. Who all can take up this data scientist role in your perception? Can all senior managers, all of us go and learn Python or all this statistical modeling and sit down and do data science? When you say you sit down and do data science, end of the day, end with the data analytics. The results of this is a data analytics. Can you all do that or stay away? Okay, we are going to get a driverless car soon. Okay, so far you know driving. We have managers, you are busy. So you kept a driver to drive the car and you have been managing him well so far. In future, we'll get into a driverless car. Will you get into the car if you do not know what happens there? Because you have been managers so far, managing our driver. Can we manage a driverless car without just understanding the phenomenon of how does it works?
No.
Not really. We cannot dream of a car then. So that's a major thing, the challenge that has come in today. For me to run a data science project, as a visionary, as a leader, if I take a chance to go through the fundamental elements of an R programming or a Python or these analytics related mathematical models, how does it works? Hardly takes me 40 hours to 60 hours to learn, but it will help me to lead the industry for next 40 years. This is the fundamental understanding of like a basic driverless car. The whole thing has changed. The transition is huge and very big. With my current SQL knowledge, can I run? Yes, possibility is there. But plus, if we have a choice to take this as an education, as a learning, as a training, just walk through those classes for minimum of 40 to 60 hours about data science. As I said, you don't need to sit at the desk and do the data scientist role, but you can lead thousands of data scientists ahead. Because your expertise is more of customer handling. Now you know the pain area. Now you know the problem. You know what possibilities the tools and technologies have got it. You can extract the work from people and guide those projects very powerfully and successfully. To lead the rest of the career for 30, 40 years, as I said, we need to spend some 20 to 40 hours at least to understand what these things are really doing. Before we get understanding of a data science, but today's market is completely talking about digital transformation. What is digital transformation then? Should we get prepared on digital transformation or data science now?
Both?
What is digital transformation? Are you hearing these words or am I only hearing this word? Very good. Moving on to cloud is digital transformation. What else is digital transformation?
Transformation versus this data analytics is like having two railway lines which are running in parallel.
Yes.
One cannot coexist without the other.
Okay.
Before we actually get into the concept of digital transformation, we need to be aligned towards understanding what the quintessence of change.
Okay.
And the reality behind perception as to why we should change.
Okay.
What are the factors behind change? If those facts are clearly artifacted, I think digital transformation and this data analytics is just a cake.
It's all in the same environment.
It's exactly
the same. Good. Excellent. What other perceptions we have? Other views, please. Yes. What other views you have about digital transformation?
It's basically changed.
Okay. Where did we get the word digital first of all? We were talking about IT and ICT. Then all of a sudden, we all got into the buzzword called digital. What is digital all about then?
Already everything is digital. Just there, I mean.
Okay, then.
New jargons
to sell business. Sell IT. To sell ourselves. User experience.
Converting a lot of legacy.
So all the paperwork has been converted into the digital mode in IT and ICT.
That's right.
So for our customers, we made everything digital, but still he is not happy. Then I told him I'll do digital transformation for you now.
Make the thing more and more.
Lifestyle is asking IBM, for the last 30 years you have been supporting us, but still my business is number 2, number 3, number 4. Whereas my competitor who is supported by Wipro is a number 1. So IBM said, don't worry, I'll do digital transformation for you. So what is that digital transformation all about now? You are right. We made everything digital first. Now we are giving digital transformation. In digital transformation, we are trying to make the X revenue of a particular business into 10X, and there is a possibility up to any number multiplied by X as per your choice. The business growth has been promised in digital transformation. It's not just providing technology, Digital transformation is not providing information technology, but proving the information technology is enabling the business growth. That is what is called digital transformation. Not just technology. I'm not just selling servers for you. Today I'm selling service for you, infrastructure as a service. After getting my infrastructure as a service, still lifestyle or some healthcare companies crying, no, 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 my business is not transformed. That is where we talk about digital transformation. So we told him very clearly, if you have purchased only infrastructure as a service, it is not full digital transformation. We try to push the other services now. Right? That the smart way we have for all our IT consumers, first we push them on the cloud. That is the step number one in digital transformation. Why should we push them on cloud? What was the problem with the non-cloud environment?
Maintenance.
Reliability. Scalability. 100 servers we have to put in the rack. All 100 servers needs a physical cable, power, cooling, everything. Then what happened? Virtualization came in. What did he do? Virtualization. What is the power of virtualization? Yes, like a Ravanan's head. Correct? It made a Ravanan's head on one physical machine. So then we talked about huge projects called server consolidations. What we did in server consolidations? Remove 100 servers from the rack, only maintain 10 servers. Because Ravanan's head, right? All 100 workloads maintained on 10 machines with virtual machines. That was the problem in terms of data growth. We are again coming to our voluminous data. When companies were enormously growing or exponentially growing in their business, large volume of data was there and computing depends on the server capacity, and more servers when you add to the rack, that become a big problem to the whole economy, ecosystem, everything. And virtualization came and stopped there and said, no, 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 you don't need to expand the servers. You'll only expand the virtual machine on a physical server. And then people came into it and virtualization came in and the cloud business model came in. Private cloud, public cloud, hybrid cloud, all these dramas. Yes, first. So first, we proved a business case to our consumers of IT saying, there is a capital expense made zero and operational expense only. So move on to the cloud. Right? So the first step in digital transformation for, because as I said, there were eras we proved like IT is helping them. That is no more. Now they wanted something else. So we told them, don't be on the traditional data centers, move on to the cloud. Then on the cloud, the other sellings also got PaaS. Platform as a service, software as a service, all these things are the additional packages. But anyhow, first we went for infrastructure as a service. Cloud was done. Now your healthcare customer, he was happy that you removed all the servers, space was less and all these things happened and he's on the cloud. Step number one is done on digital transformation. What is step number two now?
From web to mobile.
The medium of access, again a web enabled to mobile enabled, all those flexibility we brought in so that you can talk about anytime, anywhere banking, right? So when you move on to a mobile, mobility, right? When you move cloud to mobility, excellent. When you move to mobility, you said, Kiruthika, you don't need to come to the bank or stand in the counter, do everything in your mobile phone. So we gave that. Did that improve the banking business by 100x?
Yeah.
Still they are saying no. We didn't say that. We said we have done a good ROI for you. Still the bank is saying, yeah, you said move on to the cloud, we moved on to the cloud. You said mobility, then we did that anytime, anywhere banking people are doing. But still my business is not improved. I don't know why she purchased the personal loan here and car loan from the nearby bank. And paying that bank and not paying me. They got a business problem again. What is the solution then? IT overheads was a bigger problem. Cloud was the solution for it. IT overhead cost and all these things. And even any small business, overnight they can become enterprise because cloud is there. Anything you can deploy on the cloud and you can become another Microsoft tomorrow. Then we talked about mobility and the reaching at the phone level. Then still we have not solved there. It's 10x to 100x requirement. What is the next thing then? That's the whole topic all about what we are discussing today, right? Analytics. Then we encourage them. This is the first dot. Second dot, we encourage them on big data. Or you say data analytics. Or data science. This is where we pushed them next. So we told our customers very clearly, you have got large volume of data with you. What are you doing with the data? We'll send the data engineers to your office. We'll deploy these engineers. They'll find out the hidden pattern. They'll give directly the wisdom to you, not information. So far, we have been pulling the reports and we are saying powerfully, information was there from the data extracted. Information was an information. Today, they directly want wisdom, not information. They want the wisdom. Data analytics can give wisdom to the business owners. So we started selling the technologies that can empower this data science. Okay? Even in pen and paper also, people can take a data, do a mathematical model and come to a conclusion. They can do that. But with a limited size, and you got a large volume of data, then we supported them with an ecosystem. That ecosystem is called big data. You got it? Is big data and data science different now? The logic or the mathematical modeling or the understanding or the effort we put in as a project to understand the hidden pattern or the wisdom is all about data science. And that leads to a lot of insights and wisdom. The reports that you generate, this is called data analytics. But the large voluminous data cannot be normally handled with the current SQL or the other database models. It could be lively generated on live. Am I right? It should be on live. So they predict on any happenings of the business on the OLTP, right? On the online transaction processing, they wanted to understand and analyze and immediately put some insights based on insights, some triggers, some alerts, some key messages to the customers who are buying it online. So if that has to happen, we need a system, an ecosystem to handle that variety of data, the voluminous data with the high velocity. The current SQL system or the other database structures we had is not supporting it when you talk about the word called variety. What does variety means? Structured and unstructured, a combination of both. So that was not being just like that handled. So the family called Hadoop and related tools came in. What are the related tools we have in big data environment? They are called big data engineers. You now got the clarity of handling a resource from a manager perspective. A data science engineer role is different. A big data engineer role is different. You call them as engineer, administrator, associate, that's all different. But big data is a different ecosystem-based specialization. Data science is a different specialization. The both can be bridged in between with data analytics.
So you're talking about data analytics.
Yes, the outcomes of the data science, whatever you interpret, predict, and give the as a report to the management, that is all actually called data analytics. Analytics is the outcome of the data science that you apply. Data science is a concept, understanding what kind of algorithms to apply and all those things. When you apply and process it and come with the solution, that is called data analytics. Then you take it to a processing engine and get extract. We talk about that particular stage as data analytics.
Is it not another terminology for data warehousing versus business intelligence?
Yes, a very good question. How data analytics differs from data warehousing and business intelligence, data mart and all these things? Anyone can support me?
So those are all information. They just provide only information. So here, as I said, it will provide wisdom.
Okay, done. Okay.
Big data is nothing but data warehousing. Data science is nothing but business intelligence.
Data science is?
Nothing but business intelligence.
Business intelligence.
Big data is nothing but data warehousing.
Data warehousing.
Because data warehouse would also expand the large structure and then we do data massage and all those things.
Yes. But this data warehousing, if you remember, earlier we did without Hadoop as well. Am I right?
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
Answer is that.
See, the core different is a distributed big data.
Excellent.
Supporting the distributed architecture. Processing as well as data storage. Other traditional algorithms, you know to set the distribution in a different manner.
Yeah, so large volume of data, yes.
Technically, load balancer is applicable only for urban and off layer.
Yes.
None of the RDBMS are not supporting the load balancer transformer. So okay. Data is supporting.
Yes.
That is the core difference, technical difference.
Technology support that we have. Yes, excellent.
No, no, distributed warehousing we have to enable. But as default here it is supported. Distributed processing also there. No, RDBMS distributed computing we cannot get. Only storage we can send it in the DR side. Not in the BR side, right? Here in the primary itself the data is distributed. That is the core difference in the data.
Yes, please. Some of you can value add to it, yes. Yes, please. It handles both structured and unstructured data here. Yes. Unstructured as well.
Business intelligence is added here.
Okay.
Data warehousing, you are using it for multiple reporting purposes.
Yes.
Business intelligence is not added.
Yes. The data science algorithms are not wrapped on the top of it. When you wrap it, that the intelligence or the wisdom that we are looking for comes in. And we also felt that the current tools which support data warehousing is not sufficient to the velocity that we are looking for. And the new Hadoop ecosystem, as we talked about distributed architecture, the master-slave concepts of distributing the files across all the available nodes and getting the work done with a minimum given amount of time is the practical possibility that we have. That is the enhancement.
Basically, if you look at it, since you came upon the fact that data warehousing existed quite some time back.
Yes.
It was primarily with the thought that it can handle both structured and unstructured data.
Okay.
And primarily, it was built for systems which can... which need not change much.
Okay.
But if you are looking at big data and the systems generate reports on the fly and you are trying to get information at the snap of a finger,
yes.
It is a system primarily designed for change. There's a world of a difference between a prescriptive system versus an adaptive system.
Yes.
So that's
predictive versus adaptive, yes.
Adaptive system. So for plan driven versus agile.
Yes.
So this is, in my opinion, one of the key difference patterns. How you are going to actually...
This agility is the main flexibility that we have on big data. Yes.
And there we are actually the rules, the business rules, the business engines, that constitute the basic science as to how the business intelligence,
yes.
How
yes. How do you understand really what is inside depends on your data scientist wisdom, his wisdom, his more deeper understanding of the business and putting in the right mathematical model to predict what is happening inside.
And it also incorporates UX, UI.
Yes. User experience and... user interface as well. So these are all the added advantages when you move on to this. So as you have a walkthrough on the Hadoop ecosystem, we'll also get a better clarity on that. Fine. So we've identified the second dot on digital transformation. What is the next dot? To my customer, I will promise digital transformation only if he adopts these three things. First, I told him to get onto the cloud, he is on the cloud. Then I ordered him, you take big data solutions from us or data science solutions from us. And then he accepted that also. That second dot is also done. On the top of it, we are trying to sell one more and then say, now you can look for the digital transformation in your business. What is that next dot? You have the answer. Project management, yes, of course, we are the backbone to move from a non-cloud to a cloud, again from a non-data analytics environment to a data analytics environment. Yes, we have been running all these projects, plus one more. Very good, excellent. RPA. What is RPA? Robotics process automation. What is it is going to do?
Automate
the unwanted processes. What is going to do?
Automating
the automation.
No.
Yes?
See, all the yellow point activities are the support desk activities, even monitoring all the automated.
Okay. Yes. So you have a workflow. When you say L1 support and incident solving, the best known example for all of us. An incident ticket comes in, service desk has to pitch in, and they'll play the game. Right? Then they have to appoint one L1 engineer. Then from there we'll pick it up and we'll say only these two parties are involved. Now let us talk about a lead time. What is a lead time? From the time the ticket is born till the time the ticket is closed. So we take 2 hours minimum for an L1 P1 ticket, for example. If that can be made into 20 minutes, how interesting it is. Really, I'm going to do the same workaround only. We are going to reboot, instead another bot is going to reboot, that's all. End of the day is going to be a reboot only, right, after a lot of fights. You take 2 hours to reboot and say the incident is closed. I'll take only 20 minutes. A soft bot is going to do it and solve it in 20 minutes. So the workflow in between, where there is a handover to the service desk, to the technician, that is going to be wherever possible without affecting the criticality of the business. Wherever this repeatable task, which is very simple in nature, first I'll take a challenge code. I'll not automate everything, which is very much repetitive in nature, very simple in nature, but consuming a large amount of lead time. To reduce that lead time and improve that business productivity, I'm going to bring a bot in between. The ticket will be triggered to a, not a human being, to a being. Who's that being? My bot. As an incident manager of that account, I'm managing 4 beings and 2 human beings. 6 are working under me. Who are those 4 beings? Bots under my account. If those bots are not running today, today's incident will not be solved. Am I right? I have to ensure incident does not happen for my bot as well today. That's what is happening. I want 6 in my account. 2 human beings and 4 beings. The 4 beings are the bot with ID 1, 2, 3, 4. Another Ram and Naveen in my account. And I'm managing 6 persons over there. 4 beings and 2 human beings. I'm a manager of 6 persons anyhow. These 4 guys will solve the incident in 20 minutes. Another 2 guys will solve the incident in? So, such kind of automation also we are trying to do in banking, healthcare, anywhere. And the third dot is RPA. So, now we are taking a good enough amount of time, first of all, to implement digital transformation to our customers. Am I right? Our projects on digital transformations are a combination of cloud plus data analytics plus RPA together. If these 3 things are implemented in any business, then I'll tell them, now let's talk about the 10x to 100x shift. That is the culture we have created now. Are you aware of that? This is what is called simple digital transformation. All leaders are shouting. We took already 10 years to implement on cloud. Maybe we'll take another 5 years only to implement data analytics and RPA together. By 2025, excellently, all business can stay in competition only if they are on the digital transformation technologies. For sure, otherwise they'll be behind. They cannot be, you know, able to run with this his competitor for sure. So IT alone cannot enable business. These challenges, these new challenges, if this IT is not undergoing, if they're running with the traditional model of IT, those customers, we tell them that you are not digitally sound. I forgot to get a link, I'll maybe later share you a link in which you can evaluate using that form the digital strength of a customer. You can ask him some sample questionnaires. You put those questionnaires in place and ask them, are you doing this business? Yes. Are you having this technology in place? Yes, 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 no. Then the tool will automatically tell how much is the score. If you are scoring 9 out of 10 or 8 out of 10, that company has accepted digital transformation oriented technologies, then he can dream about digitally transforming his business in 10x to 20x or 15x. You got it? We have a lot of such consulting work now for managers. That is the pre-sales point where we have to work and bring in orders for digital transformation project for our companies. We have to trigger the customer to understand what is a digital economy today, what is digital transformation for them. We are the digital transformation specialist. So first, let us be allowed to check their digital capabilities in terms of adopting IT. Adopting IT has now changed into a digital capability for a business. How much they have penetrated into this digital transformation technologies, we have to check with them. So that questionnaire will be really helpful for you. So go and ask them and weigh them and show you are 3 out of 10, 4 out of 10. Sorry. So really, IT can help you, but not sure. The one which you are looking for, revenue improvisation, customer satisfaction, those things we cannot promise. We can only sell IT now, not completely your growth. Selling IT to a customer is different. Enabling business growth is different, but you're promising that in digital transformation for sure.
So
yes.
Whether data analysis is a separate role, data scientist is a separate role?
It's a little combination. Every data scientist will end up with the data analytics work. But the input is from a business analyst point also it will come in. So business analyst, data scientist, engineers all work together. Data engineer, data scientist, a combination of business analyst will come in because I talked about the domain expertise. Yes, subject matter expertise. So it's now in between overlap. And the other side of it, our big data engineers will come in. They'll set the ecosystem and give to them. They'll install Hadoop, Apache, whatever you need, like Spark, whatever you're talking about, variety of tools are there. All those things as required for extracting the data, processing the data, storing the data, visualizing the data, presenting the data. For everything, I've got a good number of tools. All the tools by names, if you understand, that would be set by a particular team for all specialists in big data. If they are big data specialists, you can expect them to set up the ecosystem only, the environmental needs only. But data scientists or data analysts, business analysts can work on a problem. Work on a business problem. They can do that.
Ma'am,
yes, please.
You have just mentioned there are three things that
yes.
You must have the cloud, then have the big data, data analytics, and
hardware. Yeah.
In order to in going for the digital transformation, is it required that the first part, the IaaS or the infrastructure is required?
Yes.
Problem here is, I already have, we have the job, okay, tools and technique for the second and the third.
Okay.
Moving to
okay.
The cloud,
okay.
Particularly for the big organization,
okay.
Is required a very, one of the toughest parts.
Very sensitive.
The existing thing
yes.
To the cloud.
Okay.
But you already had the operation.
Yes.
You had the incident.
Yes.
You have a problem.
Yes.
That part you can easily
okay.
Going ahead,
okay.
Implement it, and data automation or the automation you can go ahead.
Okay.
But I will suggest that it's, I will say
okay.
That infrastructure, IaaS,
okay.
Is not a digital transformation. Maybe we can go for the partial transformation.
Okay.
And data transformation or the cloud movement.
Okay.
It takes years.
Okay. Fine.
It's not very easily
okay.
You can move.
Okay.
Because a lot of things are there. Security aspects are there, whether you want to go for the hybrid, whether you want to go for the private.
Public,
what
private.
Is required?
Yes.
It's the management itself is confused.
Okay. So this
and
this
the security part is the one of
biggest
the
challenges.
Biggest challenge for an individual or the company to move to the
yeah, that is why we call it transformation.
Okay.
Yeah, not a small activity. So
yes, cloud was a bigger question a few years back. Now you actually settled down in that. Meaning the choice is not avoiding cloud, but being on private cloud. Very simple. It's not about avoiding cloud, it's being on the private cloud. When you already purchased a VMware product or a Hyper-V, you're on the cloud. Your own cloud. Enterprise has to be on their own cloud. And there are some non-critical business loads which needs to be connected. Then you push those things to the public cloud and take a hybrid approach. Those are all there. Yes. Of course, challenges are there, as you said, it's left to the customer's choice. But if he's not on the cloud, private cloud, his cost of IT is very high. Where he cannot have a cost savings and that becomes a bottleneck to his whole business in consuming IT.
Data movement is the biggest
product
challenge.
Have moved to cloud.
Migration and all takes time.
Migration
but
is one of the biggest challenges and there is still we are lacking.
Yes, some companies would have taken 5 years, 10
yes.
Years. It depends on your own data volume, capacity, challenges. But
7 days and the 6 days fall, then you have to go again back to the
correct.
It's very challenging moving
Yeah, the phenomenon of the project is challenging. That's where we managers come in.
So that is the business
to succeed the project. Yes.
That is the business. So we say long duration, right? That is the business for our company.
That is a project for us.
Yeah.
As long as there are such kind of projects exist, we are there.
As part of the digital economy, where does machine learning?
Next stage. You have to talk. Yes.
Part.
Yes. So if you are now look at the manager's roles and leader's responsibilities, we are toggling the team on projects from cloud to big data to RPA now. In these areas, PMI now talks about a techno-functional managerial skill, a talent triangle. They have introduced recently in version 6. What do you mean by the talent triangle? How many of you have seen the talent triangle? How does it look like? What are three elements of the talent triangle?
Leadership.
Strategy.
Technical project management.
Strategic thinking. Then becoming techno-functional skill oriented. Only if you update your PDU, 60 PDUs in these three directions, you are going to be renewed on your PMP certificate. That's the message for you. Moving forward. In this talent triangle, where my digital transformation fits in? Again, you may ask me, digital transformation is only for managers and IT in every organization. From the customer side also, they have to take the ownership. From the seller side also, you have to take the ownership. You can be a project manager from Citibank IT team, or you can be from your IBM. Or you can be the owner of Citibank itself. You are the investor, you get to know what is happening here. Where is digital transformation fits in?
All
the three, it basically covers the wonderful English word called strategic. This is going to be a strategic change for a business, am I right? For a customer, it is a strategic change. It's not like a weekly update or a monthly update, right? It's a transformation. It's a business transformation changes. The business is undergoing a lot of change in the way they handle the data for their business, basically. But we have to undergo a lot of challenges in transformation here. For them, it's again a different format in which their data is getting processed by us. They are only data owners. We are the providers of these technologies and these supports and these projects. So major upskilling transformation has to happen from our end to really prove that we can bring in digital transformation for our customers. That is the biggest challenge today industry has got. Do we have sufficient talents and managers to handle the digital transformation? Ask the question to yourself. That itself is the biggest challenge, really. It has to become very simple, like A plus B the whole square. Everybody in the industry has to understand and participate in the journey of digital transformation. We are lacking of talents to support digital transformation in the business. All the companies on their website have started talking about digital offerings. They brought in a word called digital offerings even before they gave us some trainings and other equipments as we need. It was a very fast offering that we brought in. And now today, no HR or every organization has got completely time to put in the digital transformation skill to every individual. You have to be a part of it. You have to think about it. As managers, the second part of the triangle talks about not a manager, a leader. What is a leader then?
Visionaries. Leader leads.
Leader leads.
Motivates people.
Encourage people. Yes.
Not about just leadership here.
Okay.
Correct.
Yes.
Basically, it's about servant leadership.
Servant leadership in agile economy. Yes. So we are becoming servant leaders now. Yes.
It's
about
understanding that the conventional styles of leadership exist.
Okay.
But you need to adapt yourself in such a way that it suits the present environment.
Okay.
Not just ditching away whatever you did.
Okay.
Take a leaf out of the book, implement it in the present day, such that you deliver the results the way you can see it and make sense.
Okay. Done. So we want a big differentiation between how to become a leader from a manager now. So just wearing a coat, doesn't we become a leader? Just wearing our PMI badge, doesn't we become a leader? No? What should we have then? We should have followers? A leader should have followers? Yes or no? Yes, of course. There are followers for you, your project succeeds. There are no followers in your team, they'll make you to fail, not your project to fail. They'll make you as a manager to fail. So again, all these theories are good and interesting to hear and learn, but again, it is your own perception. How do you bring in the necessary capability onto the table time to time to lead the industry? Very simple. Nobody can go and ask you to become a leader. I would have asked you to become a manager because so many years you have worked in my company, you got the expertise and experience. I can recommend you to become a manager and you would also become a manager. But something leading is beyond that. Your own perception, time to time flexibility and adaptability and the change that you bring in with extraordinary energy for yourself to lead these kind of assignments. So we are looking for leaders, irrespective of whatever designation you are given. We are talking about the servant leadership. I'm not worried about the change in the terminology called servant leadership. Leading is powerful, right? It can be a 2 weeks deliverable like an agile or a 20 weeks deliverable as I was doing project management earlier. No more project management is for 20 weeks once or 2 years once now. Even the rocket science, after 5 years, I can't say 1, 2, 3. Oh, sorry, it went to Bay of Bengal. There also it's agile now, right? You can fail faster. Early detections is possible. Agile doesn't promise us that always I will pass. Every project can fail. Has a chance to fail. Agile does not say agile projects will not fail. But agile says the likely rate of failure is very much reduced. At the cry of a customer, correct? End of the day, there is an investor, there is a sponsor who will cry if the project fails. That you can minimize. That's what we are talking about. So the second part of it, what we are talking about leadership is, we have to take a call, make sure our capabilities are being raised in terms of the digital transformation projects that are running in the organization. So you need not search just with a PMP certificate saying, I'm a certified manager. What next for me? I spent $555 to get certified. What's next to me? Why not your me promoting into the next role means this does not happen automatically nowadays. So we are managers not to lead by title. We are going to lead beyond the title. That kind of leadership capability is needed for the today's digital economy and digital transformation. The next part of it is the capability naturally what you brought in, it will align with your strategic thinking, and these things automatically brings in your techno-functional expertise. You may ask me, will I go and learn Blue Prism, UiPath, automation anywhere, what these things are? A platform to create softbots. This is again a software tool where, sorry. And create a front-end bot or a back-end bot. He asked me, Kiruthika, I got an opportunity in my company. Will you just take up a team who's going to... He asked me, will you lead this project? One guy said, Kiruthika, no, in UiPath, back-end bots cannot be done. Another team member in my team said, no, this studio will not suit for it. We had a good business case from a customer asking for a bot. I thought I got a lot of experience and exposure in so many things. So I took up the team and there was a challenge in deciding the activities of the project now. Correct? All I settled down is to do a project management plan where fundamentally I need the activities of the project. No, I got a concert. My team is going to develop a bot. I have to decide on the basic activities this bot exercise will take care. My team confused me with n number of user stories. Now physically dead, not even applying project management concept. The project is now going to run on agile and team is talking in terms of user stories. My management wants me to understand on the whole how this co-op and schedule cost will all work, but team is talking in a different English. So lack of document expertise gives me a greater pain now, first of all. What these guys are going to do is itself is not clear for me. Because being on Agile, people all said, my team said, Kiruthika, you don't need to worry about the scope on Agile. Let us start first. First two sprints, let us deliver the tail of the bot, okay? Then the middle body of the bot and the head of the bot in the next sprint all looks like very easy on theory and papers, right? As a leader, I've been indicated, told I should have the vision of the project first of all. Being Agile or non-Agile is different. I should understand the vision. I cannot prepare an aircraft and say it's Agile and next week I'll add some wheels, it will go like a ship. Will it go? Because Agile says at any time you can keep on adding the scope and changing the scope. I made one rocket and then I said no. Now I'll add some extra wheels, it will go in the ocean and sail so many kilometers. Will it happen? What is very important again for any project? Vision. To get the vision, I need this techno-functional knowledge. 4 to 6 days of class here and there I've attended to understand what are the practical business cases possible in a UiPath tool. What an automation anywhere tool can do. What a Blue Prism tool can do. The class was with Java.NET coding, but still I survived there to listen to them what is happening. But end of the day, I got the message what I wanted to have there. I got a clear business case understanding what automation anywhere tool can do and what cannot be done in UiPath. What UiPath can do well and what cannot be done in Blue Prism. That business case and that understanding helps me to drive all the teams working on automation anywhere, UiPath and Blue Prism now as a project manager. I can talk to the client and negotiate now what is possible, what is not possible. What kind of changes can be accommodated in this project? What kind of changes cannot be accommodated? I cannot survive on the word called change if you don't understand the domain knowledge and the aspects of Agile itself will not drive the project to successful. You got me? My team is very much excited. 2 weeks once Kiruthika is going to give discrete user stories, we'll do. What is not, if not connected together, it doesn't work. That's what we are emphasizing on techno-functional management, please. Today, it's time for us to upskill. Get into those areas of these three dots. If you are not catching up with these three dots as early as possible today, at least in this 1.5 years down the line, the next 10 years will be a big deal for you. You'll be completely have a different dimensions of abstraction which you'll not be able to get inside. By the time all these people who were there, they'll become managers and leaders. This is the first way of digital transformation. When you leave a gap in the first way of digital transformation, the second way of digital transformation will hesitate to adopt us. So that's the whole concept I wanted to emphasize today. What makes us so powerful? Understanding the perspective of data analytics. Yes, business data has been handled. You think using the cloud and RP and all these things are there. And all the projects are running only in these areas. These areas, when you are failing to balance this techno-functional aspect, that is where is the question mark about our designation, our role, job description, all comes into today's market. If you could soundly equip this combination of your leadership thinking with the strategic dimensions of digital transformation and the nitty-gritties of the technologies contributing at the cloud level, big data level, and the RPA level, you have a wonderful, as I said, next 50, 20 years, and you decide your retirement age. And even after retirement, you would be wanted because of the digital strength you have. If not, somebody is ready to decide our retirement date. Okay, there is no retirement if you are able to capture with the talent triangle. And moving forward, this is also going to get into other three dots: IoT, blockchain, and AI. All these things. Okay, that's way forward. We want to become rich, rich, richer, and richer, correct? So that's all there. What's next? I've been bored with my infrastructure as a service in IBM. So Watson is ready there next. Correct? Next, we all need sophistication. End of the day, customer satisfaction again. Kiruthika has forgotten to lock her car. From here, she wants to lock the car and open the car, right? That's all about IoT. That's it. another dimension of customer experience. So customers are willing to experience that, correct? So you can't avoid IoT coming in. Projects would run on those platforms as a business requirement. That's not a digital transformation, that's an additional need on the cup. Then blockchain again, the crypto concept, it has been a research for the last 30 years, so no one can stop it, you can delay it. Like we delayed using computers in the beginning, ATM in the beginning, correct? We delayed all those things in the beginning because there is always a resistance when a change comes in. So those kind of things would actually come in. So when industries came in, we were talking about mass production of the equipments and other things we need. Then industry itself was empowered by IT, that is going into a digital economy. Then blockchain is not about digitalizing or digital transformation, creating a trust, automating the trust in the business. Customers putting their card inside, there's a lot of money is involved, right? We are proving customer experience and satisfaction for our buyers. Next, we're also going to bring in an era of the trust. You're going to automate a factor called trust. That is all, not only Bitcoin is a sample application. In every area, we cannot avoid solutions being built on blockchain. You can't avoid it, you have to live with it. That's what I said, there is no retirement for us. Managers are becoming so powerful if you are adaptive in nature. Okay, so this is the six dots in terms of technological know-hows or the techniques that you have to master yourself to stay tuned to that today's business world. And the fundamental to everything is data analytics, no doubt about it. Okay, it starts with cloud.
Manager has to master.
Leader.
Instead of managers should have the big picture.
Yes.
And they should be knowing where, which one they need to use it or adopt it. Because becoming a master, which I feel it is.
You become the master over a period of time. As I said, you have to just know the first step. You make the first step in all these areas. As I said, 20 hours of self-learning, 40 hours of some coach-based learning, 60 to 120 hours, 40 hours of college-based learning. People are competing for that learning here. It could be an awareness session today, right? A detailed training session later, and education itself is your choice in these areas. But my suggestion is these things cannot be avoided. If you avoid this, you don't have projects for you.
Yeah, actually,
so that's what we are working at. As I said, the simple example is the driverless car I told you. Try to understand it. If it stops 20 kilometers after, you have to troubleshoot it basically when there is no service center nearby. What has gone? What is where you have to stop? How will you tune it? What is going to happen? Just on, that's what we are looking at. We don't want you to do at the desk level work, but when you know the techno functional, as you work along with the people, you grow with them and you will naturally master it. It cannot be avoided. Mastery cannot be avoided. It will naturally happen. Okay? The right side of the wing of digital transformation is your quick capability to connect with the cloud, with the big data, with this RPA and this IoT, blockchain, till artificial intelligence. RPA will be already done. By the time as we master, our bots will start mastering themselves, correct? They'll start learning, adopting. That's what the smart RPA, what we call it as machine learning, artificial intelligence, deep learning, all these concepts connected together on the wonderful data again coming in. And even till that stage, data analytics plays a role. In all those learning patterns, data analytics is the core. So my humble request is do not avoid the understanding and spending your time on how data science, this data analytics, big data works. At least for a few hours. Get into it, you will feel a wonderful difference around. You'll be able to participate and listen to what your leaders of the company are speaking about digital transformation now. That would be a lively participation from your end. When they comment about digital transformation, business in digital transformation, all of us has to take a pre-sales as well. Sales come pre-sales plus project, why not? Right? So that is how we have to convince a customer to get into this digital transformation projects. That is where you will be sound enough to create good agreements, contracts, SLAs, am I right? So these all has to happen with our understanding. A data engineer cannot create an effective contract for a data science project where a project manager can create an effective contract. The fundamentals, if you are there, we are really great. This is one side of the digital transformation. As I chosen the V shape, there is the other part of it. Another six dots here. This is what we are all experiencing, and the version 6 has brought in Agile handbook within PMBOK purposefully. Why? Well, new combination of technologies. It's not completely changed. New combination of, we call them as disruptive technologies, correct? Business is facing a disruption, a challenge, and a change. To handle the disruptive market, these kind of combinations we have brought in as a solution in the IT industry. Now Agile has come in. Why?
The manager should be adaptable for these disruptions.
Very good.
Fail fast.
Fail faster. Now it's like olden stories when you go and meet a customer and say, I'm taking a project for you for 24 months. At the end of the 24th month only, I'll show you how your baby looks like. Is that okay? Customer says, no. The newly started company says, every 2 weeks, you'll show me how my baby is growing. Agile is not equal to prototype, really. Yes, of course, few stages could be, right? So, to handle the disruption, our approach should also be faster. Very simple. Customer is ready to spend. He wants to see next week that digital transformation is happening, at least through enabling something on the Flipkart. Right, we are going to do a bigger project on Flipkart doing data analytics. But what if the next week sales is being supported by us for a record? So customers, again, they are very clear now. They wanted us to be on Agile. The entire vision of the whole project remains same. But how do you handle these kind of disruptive technologies in a sprint model? What is sprint all about? The whole concept, break it into chunks. 2 weeks, 4 weeks, 6 weeks, 8 weeks, or even 12 weeks is also okay for me, depending on the business model. You break it into pieces, connect it, prove that your team does not have a technical depth in connecting this. It's not easy to put everything part by part and connect it. That is more tougher than the regular projects. If you are not able to do, we say there is a technical depth. Now it is very strongly articulated that managers with the best practices of predictive project management alone cannot survive. We also need an adaptive project management in place. So how adaptive our approach is in handling the project life cycle? Here it's again a project life cycle. Instead of collecting requirements once, designing once, delivering it once, every iteration, requirement, design, deliver. Requirement, design, deliver. Requirement, design, deliver. We connect across the iterations and integrate them. So that is the first change that we have brought in our project management practices to adopt to the digital transformation world. That's why, again, for all of you, Agile practices are unavoidable. You should be a part of that. You should run successful Agile projects. The designation may be a Scrum Master or a Product Owner, or you have got Safe Framework above Agile. These are all designation capabilities, but you understand the entire phenomenon as an Agile coach here. Act like an Agile coach. What is an Agile coach? Bringing in a digital transformation project inside and proving that your company can do that for the customer is an Agile coach. Agile coach is not about teaching. Agile coach will implement digital transformation oriented technologies in an Agile approach. That is why we are all scaling up to those requirements today. One is Agile. Then there are a lot of projects which has to come with a Lean Six Sigma approach. What is Lean Six Sigma approach? So these are the areas, now you understand where we go and fit in as project managers. What is Lean Six Sigma approach again? One company said, no, Kiruthika, we bought your cloud, we gave digital data analytics, we brought that, we bought everything, but still my hotel is not running well. So visited that hotel and saw what is happening there. Customer satisfaction is very poor. Their food and all is fine. So they're manually washing the plates. We went and observed the process and said, washing the plate should be automated to be faster. That change made that hotel number one. So sometimes we are not only working on a digital transformation for them, on a process transformation also we do. We understand the hotel process and see where are these processes are getting delayed in terms of your outputs. That non-value added is a waste removing, correct? Lean approach, a lean mindset. Again, why Six Sigma there? Depending on the defects or the bugs, depending on the industry, again put some statistics, probability graph and all, and try to understand how that can be taken as a project. We'll cost for two projects now. Before making him to digitally go green, we'll first make him to make his process strong. Without a process being strong, or there are a lot of gaps in the business process itself, you go and apply all your digital transformation technologies, still 10x would come to 5x. None of us are aware of that. I thought I'm very happy. Our company has got one digital transformation project. My team was doing a wonderful job. All our project was successful. Customer was paying like anything in Agile project. Payback period was so good, so super. Our company enjoyed. Customer was also very happy when I showed them every 2 weeks. But end of the 6th month, he was working on the ROI. Earlier, what I was making was this. Now I'm spending only this much for you, but I didn't see any difference. Now they started asking us, where is that X? 10X to 5X it has come in now. Then we all got scared. Our project was successful, but the patient failed, dead. Customer was literally crying. Your company said so and so, 100 years experience company, you brought in all Watson insert and did, but there is no growth. Why this happened? So we have got another project on the top of our digital transformation project. First of all, streamline the process, check the process capability. That's what we teach in Six Sigma, process capability, right? Check for the process capability. What it is capable of yielding now, from where to where you want to move it through digital transformation, that focus, that culture you will get to know if you have some essence in your mind on the Lean Six Sigma perspectives. That will trigger you to understand and analyze a project. Is it really worth to go for digital transformation first? So this is a process-wise change that is there. And as I said, when Agile happens, the third dot, safe. What is safe? Scaled Agile frame. An Agile project happens in an organization, like a program, when you group so many other iterations and all releases together. Again, the best practice of handling the Scrum teams and Scrum of Scrums, those bottlenecks, those challenges need some process within small groups. Small group handling capability are being handled by SAFe. So as a manager, I get to know Agile, I get to know SAFe, I get to know Lean Six Sigma perspectives. I'm able to bring in a right project inside and groom these teams to deliver this digital transformation outputs. Then on the top of all these things, you are being chosen as a leader because you are being PMP certified as well. Yes, everything is a customization on the top of your project management capabilities. And then on the 5th and 6th dot, we have got two things called SIAM and Verizon. How many of you have heard about it? SIAM and Verizon. V-E-R-I and S and M again in caps. What is SIAM all about? Service integration and management. Now Citibank is crying. Kiruthika, IBM is talking about digital transformation. Infosys is talking about digital transformation. TCS is talking about digital transformation. You guys are every 2 weeks delivering. IBM is delivering every 3 weeks and Infosys is delivering every 2 weeks. End of the day, my Citibank is crying. The operations faces a release 2 weeks from this team because some assignment data, big data, they have given him. Some assignment they have given to another company. 4 or 5 companies are releasing in agile fashion inside the Citibank account. Correct? My Citibank is now crying, oh no, no, stop that. We are not able to bear it. This change is very enormous and we are worried. My security team is not giving a concerns to go ahead. What will you do then? There's one more business for us then. One of the IT companies becomes the prime contractor. This prime contractor says, Citibank, you don't cry. You give this Infosys, TCS, Wipro, everybody to me. As Accenture, I'll solve all this as an integrated change dashboard. That's a big business now. A lot of people are secretly learning this. You don't know. I expose this today to you. A lot of leaders are doing all these things in secret only. SIAM stands for Service Integration and management. It's not something new. Whatever you have learnt in your ITIL or ITSM practices, thinking from controlling four more companies being the top IT provider, that's it. That race is going on. That's already started. It's already there. So we need people to say, I'm not a service delivery manager. I'm a service integration manager. Service delivery manager would deliver for one company. Service integration manager would deliver behalf of all the companies to Citibank. The same incident management, problem management, change management. Another theoretical framework about whatever digital transformation technologies I spoke, it is called Verizon. Valuable, evolving, responsive, integrated service management. So there is no competition for ITIL so far, right? So we brought in a new framework called Verizon. Valuable, evolving, responsive, integrated service management. SIAM and Verizon certifications are available from EXIM. One of the oldest vendor who gives certification, their exams are available. That's all like 1 or 2 day sessions to understand what new elements of thinking they have brought in. As leaders, we learn from different authors. These materialistic subjects like SIAM and Verizon will also give us a focus on how to handle the challenges in terms of best practices. This full capability understanding is called the word digital transformation. As managers, we are a part of it in this era now. So we ensure how do we balance this new practices, because the digital technologies that has come in, these things you cannot balance or implement without this new approach to the best practices. Traditional best practices of project management, ITIL, these are all there already. On the top of it, these customized best practices also, if you know, failing faster, delivering faster, giving everything as per the customer's wish, digitally transforming from 10x to 100x, all these things are possible. So this is the secret of the word digital transformation for the managers, and we ensure as much as possible we equip ourselves with these things. Get to know them, get close to them and see, start observing what is happening. So you put a tick mark and find out your digital age now. Out of this two, I'll put the scores and find out. Get the scores for yourself. You need not disclose to me.
Let's not spoil the weekend.
So now there is a basic question for now, because I do teach PMP and all. People ask me, Kiruthika, how about getting PMP certified? After I get PMP certified, I'm not getting a job. Just a PMP does not promise anything. It's promising you everything, I would say. It gives the power to lead. What else you need first, right?
You know, the main challenge in digital transformation for a manager is paper use. And all these things goes in favor of the customer.
Yes.
The company who is providing you the service, they are struggling how to make maximum for the revenue. Everything is going with the space, all you provide. Service
okay.
Goes by. Earlier days, we were going okay, 8 hours working.
Okay.
These many hours per hour. This is the thing. Now, the thing is, what is happening for a manager? How to see their resources are maximized? Otherwise, the company is very difficult to survive. A company who is in the very nicely managed, they can able to survive. But in the current scenario, where everything is goes in favor of the customer.
Yes.
They are paying what they were servicing.
Yes.
And that is the area which requires for all the company to see how they can able to survive in this case.
This is the situation. Yes. There
yes.
is a tough time.
Yes.
Even big companies are
yes.
competing for their survival at a less cost.
Very, very.
Yeah, they are
acquiring.
Big companies are acquiring the talent. Wherever there are 100 people, they have a talent, right? So they are acquiring. That is the only way they are.
many applications are happening.
It's a bigger race within IT companies
big
itself.
Race, big race.
All companies cannot be a successful digital transformation company again. Again, we have to optimize the resources, and at an affordable cost, we have to create digital transformation for our customers. That is where we are all in. That is the bottleneck. That is the challenge. That is where we still prove we lead and help the company support the customer and our organization. We can jump between companies, but we cannot stop learning these things.
The company only wants, for which we are servicing,
okay,
they only want to focus on their business.
Yes.
And everything is being outsourced.
Yes.
Cloud concept is basically companies outsource everything. The entire IT infrastructure has to be outsourced. You focus only on the business.
Yes. That is the core work we are promising to the customers. You tell them, you give money and give me everything, I'll take care. That's all. You only focus on your work. You come and tell me your ideas, why your customers are not visiting your showroom, such kind of business data, if you could collect, give me the best data. That too, we should know when we're working on the analytics, what data quality and all these things are there. To take the right data and start processing on it, then you'll be able to survive.
So, with respect to data, BigBazaar is coming out with various options to collect the data. What
correct
customer is purchasing?
Yes.
You 10,000, you can purchase for 12,000.
Correct.
So every month you can come and purchase and get the 100 rupees voucher. So they are collecting the complete data.
Very good. And they are giving me a coupon saying, Kiruthika, 2,000 rupees there in your hand. But you have to purchase something in a particular section where I spend another 30,000 rupees next. I was dreaming of the 2,000. I never read it properly really. I was telling my sister, soon before it expires, you have to go to that BigBazaar and all. She said, don't you know that first time you got that coupon? She asked me, yes, I saw it recently. No, you have to take another 30,000 into your purse to spend that 2,000 rupees. Then I said, okay, I'll stop. Then I'm not sure that I'm going.
I think it's about two things. One is getting the requirements correct versus correct requirements. But the entire most of this session is primarily articulated on that.
Done. So, hope you enjoyed digital transformation, how big data is going to influence our life, and how we are connecting that with project management. Now we are all behind the data. Rest all, there are so many universities and even institutes like us to teach you what you have to learn. We are all behind the data for the business and connect with any technology as much as possible. This powerful tools, big data, data science and analytics plays the big three in the industry. And when you say data science, statistics, technology, domain expertise, all combinations. So basically, data science is helping to solve a customer problem, either to cross-sell or upsell. End of the day, it ends with sales only. Sales is the customer satisfaction and money creation part. So we can create any number of problem statements like this. We need a lot of managers and consultants today with the domain expertise. I've been in telecom for so many years. I've been in healthcare for so many years. That is an asset for you. That's a cash cow for you. Being a domain expertise, you can go and talk to them, tell them about the problem that exists in the business. Data scientist will then start working on that only. He will not create problems. He will not be able to create problems. So we can just talk about it, discuss. So they are telling like, you know, people are not buying much nowadays. What would I do? Data scientist will say, Kiruthika, don't worry. I use probability theory and a priori algorithm to tell you why they are not buying. That's all he'll say.
Now, that Agile and the cloud put together are changing over to DevOps now. Does it have any change here?
Yeah. Yes. When you talk about DevOps, again, development and testing was brought inside Agile. When you put the third thing, sorry, operations teams together, we brought in a new culture on the top of it that was called as DevOps. And even we now have DevSecOps, security. Yes. People are running there now. What is DevOps again? Another challenge to the project manager. My team, I removed the wall between development and testing, said all of you are together, do everything they ran and did. Then I handed over to my friend in the release gate. He said, no, Kiruthika, your team has not done what is required. I will stop. It is not release ready. What happened now? Same thing happened in Microsoft a few years back. There was a release of a new version planned in 2 years. And the team was almost done in the last 6 months. Release team gave a bigger bug saying, no, this cannot go live this year at all. But still Microsoft released it. Okay, so what happens here is, we are already on a faster mode And if there is another specialization in the third gate saying you are not ready, we want them to sit with us from the beginning. That's all DevOps all about.
What is DevSecOps?
Including security principles as you develop, as you test, and as you deploy. Because compliance issues will be on the end. Again, another gate will stop us saying don't go live. Okay, we talk about technically their CI/CD, continuous integration, continuous deployment, continuous delivery. Three terms are there. What is continuous integration? The release engineers also give their views. So you have got a big DevOps canvas. If you all could connect it back, I don't have the slide. A big DevOps canvas, right? First having your Git for a source code and then going into Jenkins for build and then Selenium for testing automation. So I am a developer, he's a tester, he's a release engineer. I put my code in one repository. From there, the code will transfer the files to him. He has already written a script for testing. It will automatically test. From there, that will transfer to him. We don't do a manual transfer. We all talk via tools. So our development, like Git, Jenkins, Jira. Jira is basically workflow automation. Jenkins, then the Selenium, and this Rackspace, all these combinations. So what we do here wonderfully is with the tools, DevOps tools automation. Agile automated use DevOps again. Agile, you can speak in theory for hours and hours and days, but in real project implementation, we should have a DevOps ecosystem, like big data ecosystem, we should have a DevOps ecosystem. So the moment I finish my coding in the first 4 hours, I can deploy it rail. It will automatically run a build, go to some few test cases, go to the production and check, Kiruthika, what you gave in the morning, that user screen is perfectly working. I'll be happy to add one more screen in the afternoon. So every 4 hours, my work is being tested for readiness. And at the end of the week, release is planned. If 4 or 5 features were really working, 6th one not working, that alone you can stop and still go live. So that's called about CI/CD pipeline. That's again another environment where you've got a lot of things to do now. All who are leading, the managers leading all the development assignments, we are working with a team which has not undergone any change. But the only change is the tools are being installed there in the name of DevOps and Agile culture. That we call it as DevOps culture also now, because development, testing, operations brought together. So that is an extended view of Agile again, you are right. It fits in here, DevOps. Okay, so my data scientist, if you give a problem about the company, he will tell you what your problem is really in terms of some analytics with a mathematical modeling. He'll tell you why people are buying or not buying. So what data science actually gives you? What is the power? ROI is there. What it gives? It eliminates the guess. And also, I likely to pass. It will actually tell you what happens. In your CASSP exam, they made it like so adaptive now. 90 questions when you cross, there are a few more questions, right? Within 90, whatever you did, that plus remaining, if you do also, you will not be able to pass, they'll stop you at 90th question. Saving time and energy, right, for a test center. Earlier people used to sit and write the whole 3 hours. Now they are not writing 3 hours in my center. Some guys goes in half an hour. I told what happened. 90th question, it stopped me. I don't know why it stopped me. We know why it stopped. We just said okay. I can't say that you have been stopped for this reason. That's not the right time to tell you. If I read the policy document, he would have known on his own. So this is again a data science, right? So nothing is being guessed. It gives what they need to really do in their business. So that's the power of data science. So let us be a part of it when you do that digital transformation to our customers. And it's not restricted to any industry specifically. Anywhere you can apply it and enjoy it, having the domain expertise. A data scientist, whichever industry he goes in, specifically now today data scientist, they don't need to have a data, you know, what you call domain knowledge, but there will be someone to complement that. They'll work only on this. They'll build the data set, organize it, collect it, mine it, use right algorithms. This is what they do. So new budding engineers are coming in, data scientists, data engineers. We managers have to equip them in our projects. So we should know what kind of expertise and experience is expected out of them. Even if they are able to tell about some algorithm names also, today we are recruiting them. Somebody says a priori algorithm, I said get in first. Because we don't have resources, so we are okay with them. They are going to be the first of its kind engineers for my company. Once they come in, whatever business problem we give, then they'll discover, prepare the data, model it, build it, optimize it, again they'll come back to me only. Why? I only assign them the project, right? Whatever problem was given is in terms of the data. For a particular area, you gave them the data. They'll work and come back to me, to the board, to communicate the results. Board has to take the decision. I'm a part of the steering committee, right? Now people look at me. Kiruthika, I've been talking about in hours and hours about data science. No, come on, chalo, tell me now what to do. Again, for decision making, the results will come to us only, right? So first we have to also confirm these guys have brought in the right results, correct? So that's what. The data analytics phenomenon you understand, you will be able to act on the results very smartly as a manager. The whole process goes like this. For your business, for our customer, what they really need to solve as a problem, and understand the problem, collect the data, process the data, explore it, analyze it, and communicate the results. That's the whole phenomenon about data science. And the other extended part of it, naturally we call it as analytics, and we use the big data environment to process it. A lot of young engineers are very crazy in this role now, right? There are a lot of talent hunt for data scientists. What they should actually be good in? Understanding the mathematics. We need not go in deep inside that. We can just predict it, understand it, learn it, but they have to apply it very carefully. So they have to work on it and they have to help the organization, and they'll be paid more. They actually work on the data and give back the results to us, as I gave you in the previous slide. Yes, please.
So, we have all the options available. Another option to make sure how much the accuracy is what I'm getting the output. Do you have any verification and validation of the output which we are getting? I'm applying all these six algorithms, that's fine. But what is the guarantee that the output of this algorithm is what is the real expectation? Do you have any verification and validation kind of?
Yes. So, those things is basically a statistics question. If you can understand, no, there is something called as lift power. There are some terminologies which you predict in those results, like confidence coefficient. So these statistics, when you apply, there are some results in the terminology of confidence coefficient, lift. When I get an answer like lift, from that factor, I derive a conclusion. This business can be changed from making one person buying one soda, he can make four sodas, buy four sodas, something like that. So when you go through that statistics once, you will try to understand. There are a lot of what you call as conclusions, like mean, median, mode you have. From that, you arrive at a conclusion, like what frequency people are buying certain things. The same way, this will give you a conclusion. You have to understand which parameter talks about what. And collectively, those results will help us to make decisions. This is what you would have heard. I frequently hear these words, MongoDB, Hadoop, HDFS, Hive, Pig, Scoop, Impala, Kafka. What these things are? Very modern tools, correct? Which makes us to fear. They're just casual tools. As you can work with your Yahoo Mail, Gmail, I would tell you, you can work with these things. They're all very simple, but very fancy and attractive to see. They're all very simple. You know what their purpose is. That's all. We don't need to become a big data specialist for sure. Just understand the underlying architecture. Which tool fits in which step in that ecosystem. Just the 10 hours of learning will make you a big data specialist as a manager. The rest the team will take care. Okay? In a big picture, when you do billing, this is how data science projects flows. You put in a very formal solution map like this, correct? These are a formal way of building an assist phase to the to-be phase in our project. So we'll try to cover how, this is a very formal slide, talking about collecting the data, then ingest, do experimentation, give the insights to the business, then how you transform the customer's wish. End of the day, customer has a wish. He wants to grow his business. We are going to help him to grow. We are empowering him with that growth capability. And people also used to talk about in the market, usually they talk in a combination of all these things. Data science tools, big data tools, analytics tools, with all the combinations they usually speak. Now you can filter where they are talking about big data, where they are talking about data science. Data science basically need the applying an R programming skill, Python skill, and SQL for sure to work on the data, and they'll connect to even an Oracle engine and other existing database engines and all warehousing tools, they'll connect basically. So this is what has happened. The managers have seen these three eras so far. So we have started in a period of where mass production happened, and talking about IT in terms of digital economy. Moving forward, we are also making solutions to automate the trust of our customers. Recently, there was a talk in a particular forum in Singapore. There one person presented digital transformation as this. That is the fundamental that I have given. So people are cooking it, you know, whatever is happening. They call this as ABCD of IT. I was wondering what they are talking beyond what I was discussing. They just put this in four words. ABCD is talking about artificial intelligence, blockchain, cloud, and data analytics. So wherever I went and see, they are not avoiding data for sure. However, they simplify my 12 dots to 4 dots also, still my analytics is there. So that makes us to feel and understand the importance of data analytics. All these efforts when you put in, you're going to spend a very less time in decision making and guiding, coaching, bringing in all your team. So your 90 minutes of your work sometimes is going to enhance the entire team's capability for months and years of the entire project. When you lack a technical depth, then that is the biggest challenge for us. So that's the message about our talent triangle as well, right? Why we approved in the talent triangle saying you should become a leader or strategically sound or technically sound. So our minutes and seconds of work is going to make a big transformation to our company and our customer. So that's the message. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. It's a wonderful session for the morning. Now I may invite Mr. Ragumani to hand over the momentum.